should start with the end of this book. The last phrase is, words are the winner. Is that the power of writers and books?
Well, what I was trying to suggest is that history is about powerful people. You know, history is about kings and generals and billionaires and, you know, so on. But when they're all dead and gone, what remains is the stories told about them. And that is what survives. You know, so actually, even though writers have no armies and they have no billions, except for J.K. Rowling, they have that power, which is to define the age. You know, I mean, if we now think about, you know, if we think about Napoleon's invasion of Russia, we think about War and Peace. You know, and that's the book that seems to capture that historical moment. You know, so it's kind of rather wonderful that writers who have very little power in their lifetime have that power in the afterlife. Lorca was murdered by the Falange, but the poetry of Lorca has outlived Spanish fascism. You know, and so that's the thing that writers can do. You know, they can outlast the thing that opposes them.